Are you willing to pay the price for following Christ? Is there a price for following Christ? Charles Price calculates the price for following Jesus in this book. Let me read a portion from this book. I have often been asked the question, how much do I have to give up to become a Christian? I used to answer that by saying something like, well, it all depends, and would then be as careful as I could so as not to frighten the inquirer, and to indicate it was only the things that were bad for us anyway that we had to give up. I do not say that anymore. In answer to the question, I reply, everything. Jesus said, any of you who does not give up everything he has cannot be my disciple. Luke 14:33. That does not mean that Jesus will take everything away, but that everything I have will now function under his authority and be conducive to his purposes. Apart from that, I cannot be a disciple. Do not, as I have sometimes heard done, distinguish between being a Christian and being a disciple, with the idea that discipleship is on a deeper level. The word Christian began only as a nickname for disciples. The disciples were first called Christians at Antioch, Acts 11:26. It is as a disciple that one earns the right to be called a Christian. And therefore, if I am not a disciple, fulfilling the demands of discipleship, I am not a Christian. Does all this sound tough? Does it all sound one-sided, with me giving Christ everything? What does his role as Lord mean to me, you may be asking? We will think about that now. But all the many exciting benefits of his lordship in our lives are possible only as we come to terms with the cost and as we are willing to pay it. So, this is the cost. This is the price that a potential disciple has to pay. Earlier in this book, in fact in the previous page, we read, this is a picture of the kind of relationship into which we must come with Christ. He is to be given exclusive rights as the authority in our lives, to the exclusion of everything else, even legitimate and good things. This is why Jesus made the statement, if anyone comes to me and does not hate his father and mother, his wife and children, his brothers and sisters, yes, even his own life, he cannot be my disciple. Luke 14:26. This is not to say there is anything wrong in having a father, mother, wife, children, brothers or sisters. Of course not. These relationships are good, right, and should be some of the best on earth. But Christ takes priority over the things that are right and good, as well as over things that are bad. After reading this book, the picture has become much clearer as far as I'm concerned. I must endeavor to be a disciple of Christ. I must not endeavor to be a Christian, but I must endeavor to be a disciple. And only if I'm a disciple, I can be a Christian. And to be a disciple, I need to surrender to the Lordship of Christ. Christ is Lord, and I must accept Him as Lord. I must make Him my Lord. This is the price I have to pay in order to be His disciple. Are you willing to pay that price today?